All right.
Welcome to our house, our basement.
Our stream. It's not a basement, it's a den.
Okay, I'm sorry. Basement, but to be fair, so with these depressing. Walls, it looks like we're in a basement.
It looks like we're in a den.
Okay, fine.
Because it's wood panel.
So who are
you?
Oh, hi, everybody. I'm classically Abby, and this is my husband,
Jacob.
Jacob Roth. Mm-hmm. And we're going to be playing BioShock today and talking about it and why it's, what its ideas are. Jacob, go into it a bit.
Sure.
Before you do, how you connected to Yaff?
Oh, yeah. Jacob, what do you do?
First time we're getting our feet wet in these territories and everything like that. So I am a staff attorney for Young America's Foundation, and Abigail is the first conservative influencer. And so
we figured
there was a natural middle of the Venn diagram between what Abigail does in her way, what Yaff does in its way.
And what you do. Yeah.
Well, and so one of those aspects of overlap is just trying to reach people where they're at and what entertains them and get some conservative themes out there. It happened to be that we were talking at the office about BioShock a few weeks ago and about the themes in it. And so isn't that just a leftist game just criticizing capitalism? Yes, BioShock does criticize capitalism. It criticizes objectivist hyper-libertarianism.
Insane libertarianism.
But in that critique, even though it's from a left perspective, it actually opens the door to considering conservatism and how it rounds out things in that hyper-libertarian depiction in Bioshock, and how a lot of the problems in the society of Rapture in Bioshock have a conservative answer for how you avoid going that wrong.
Right, and so it's not that capitalism in all of its, you know, different iterations is a terrible thing. It's that capitalism, when taken to this extent...
And shorn of everything else that conservatism has to teach... Yeah, okay, you're going to get an underwater city filled with genetic mutants bashing each other's brains in while everything melts down or leaks, which is what we're about to see.
Essentially. Although, what I will say, there are some great things about this game, which we have played before. And so one of the things that I liked is that I'm terrible at video games. Warning, just everyone should know I'm very bad. My husband can do it. I'm not very good. But I can actually play this... Not well, but I can play it. So that's great. And then the other part of it is that the visuals are pretty cool. I really like it, even though this game is pretty old.
Yeah, 2007 about.
Oh my gosh, really?
I'm going to get us underway.
Yeah, go, start. Yeah.
Well, actually, there are a lot of questions. Very excited rolling in. Is this live?
This is live! Well, we're doing it right now!
Yeah, if you're asking the question, is this live, it's in the chat. We are responding to that. So yeah, there you go. That's your verification. We are, in fact, live.
What chat are you watching?
We're watching the Twitch, the Yaf Twitch. We're watching the Yaf Twitch. Yes. So if you're on my channel right now or any of the other social feeds, you can head over to the Twitch channel if you want to like start writing in comments and stuff like that.
And I will switch on over to the live scene of the game now.
Yeah. So what should we do? Easy, medium, hard, or survivor?
We are still doing easy.
Thank you.
Because it's a combination of trying to stunt on the game, explain our point of view, everything like that, and just take it in. And then also to make it so that we're not retreading the same territory over and over again
should our
brains bashed in by a genetic mutant.
So I did want to quickly mention, also the music in this game is great, I love it, but also that there is violence in this game for my followers who are more sensitive to that.
They told me, son,
should I not talk? Let's
give the case. You're special. You were born to do great things. You know what? They were right.
Observing the chat.
I know we've got our phones here so that we can see what y'all are saying.
So someone is saying lower game audio. So okay.
There we go.
Moderating that.
But the reason we can play this game and there's violence in it and I feel comfortable playing it, even though this was something that I had to get more used to, is violence in video games, is I figure if in something like this you're learning a lesson, it's teaching you something, and it's there to provide value for the game. Quite all right, so...
Yeah, so Abigail broke a traditionally conservative...
Should I swim around?
Yeah, you should swim around and try not to either drown or burn to death. So Abigail was raised in a more traditionally conservative religious household, as I'm sure so many of you are familiar with her family. On my end of things, I grew up watching action movies. I grew up watching R-rated and then some movies.
I mean, I definitely watched action movies. This wasn't, like, the really, really bad stuff. I didn't really know. Okay, I never watched a horror movie. This is horror, and
I grew up with all this stuff, right. So I have no personal problem with it. But I, coming from a more libertarian background to conservatism, I now appreciate more of the traditionally conservative people who have an issue with a lot of volatile graphic content. Nonetheless, it's important to engage with the culture. I like all this stuff, and I think there is definitely a lot of value to engaging with what's there, just not sinking to a low level because you happen to like it.
Okay, so we're looking around, and it says, no gods or kings, only man.
Yeah, that's a great start to society, is to elevate yourself and yourself
alone. Yeah, exactly, right?
I will say, if I can take the controls for a moment, one of my favorite things is just you walk in, and this game has an amazing sense of art. You just walk in, and then Andrew Ryan's
terrifying.
Just he's staring down at you, and you have a good sense of the Art Deco that's going to be beaten over your head the entire game. Just, I don't know, these moments are what made Bioshock games as art, is just actually good art design for the architecture that makes you want to walk
slowly. Well, that's the thing about this game that I liked when we played the first time, is that it puts you in this world, and it's a world that, like, it's cool that there's an Art Deco world underwater. That's cool. It just happens to be a terrible society.
They have science, they have industry, they have art. What more could you possibly want?
Well, and it's funny because it says no gods or kings, only man, and then Andrew Ryan's head is so large, he's clearly the god and the king. So.
No, totally not.
I'm sorry, that's crazy. How could I even say it? So we're in a water elevator, is that right? Oh, there we go.
Yeah, so make sure that you pan the camera around to admire everything. I'm just checking on the audio context in here.
I apologize in advance. Mm-hmm. Oh, there's going to be talking.
Yeah, they get priority.
I'm sorry.
I am Andrew Ryan, and I'm here to ask you a question. Is a man not entitled to the sweat of his brow? No, says the man in Washington, it belongs to the poor. No, says the man in the Vatican, it belongs to God. No, says the man in Moscow, it belongs to everyone. I rejected those answers. Instead, I chose something different. I chose the impossible. I chose rapture.
Ooh.
City where the artist would not fear
the, the cinematography,
the scientist would not be bound by
so choice.
Around,
yeah.
Where the great would not be constrained by the small. And with the sweat of your brow, rapture can become your city as well.
And I love that they do this because it shows what it should have been and what it was briefly. Mm-hmm. And then throughout the rest of the game, you're seeing what it turned into.
Sorry, just taking in the panorama. Also, the use of puns there. I think that was the first sign that this society was going downhill. Surprise, games of chance.
I didn't even get that.
Not for a moment could a society that lets that be the form of your ambition possibly survive.
Right.
So yeah, get ready for assault by horror movie mooks in a moment.
Yeah,
once the
that will be happening again for the followers of mine who are more sensitive to that stuff. That will be happening quite a bit in this game. Are there any good messages?
Observe for yourself.
I got a scroll. Someone asked earlier, and I think they were being sarcastic, but I'm gonna ask you anyway. What's the most classic video game?
Mario.
Okay,
yeah, the original. It's distilled to its purest form. Little jumping and platforming with whimsy and nonsense.
Oh gosh, do I have to hit someone immediately? What do I do?
Yeah, you forgot.
I forgot everything. Yes.
Now you're gonna see this man get gutted by this woman.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah. So, observe his last moments.
Okay. Blood.
And
got
there she goes.
Okay.
He's having a good time.
Yeah. It does not look great.
No, it's fine. He's having a great time. This is his self-achievement and actualization and rapture. Yeah, that's what he came here for. That's his highest end.
Are those his hands, or does he have
no,
hooks?
No, she heats them up and makes them glow. And then when you fight this kind of enemy in the game, they're called a spider slicer, because they fall on walls. They launch the hooks at you,
okay,
and they're
well
on fire.
Can I be honest? Which one is Minecraft?
I'll explain later.
Is that the one where you like build?
Yeah, you build a lot, you mine a lot. It's got that deliberate 8-bit style.
Okay, I'm supposed to pick up a radio.
You simply must.
Where
you
is
must
it?
Kindly look for the glowing radio on your right.
On my... Oh, I found it.
Yeah, did you?
Well, I have to wonder.
You gotta look up. Now grab it. There you go. Conceive, believe, achieve.
This is gonna be a lot of this stream, is me asking Jacob what I'm supposed to do at this point. I'm not great at controlling the camera either, so hopefully I don't make any mistakes.
Okay,
I've got a goal to get to higher ground.
I won't leave you twisting in the wind.
Okay. So looking around. Just showing it off to everybody. They haven't seen the game.
We're gonna need to draw her out of hiding, but you're gonna have to trust me.
So that's not something. Okay, should I look outside
for them? You may. A thing with game design is they will light the way, so there's like an intuitive sense of where to go.
Okay.
So the game usually is shepherding you just by implicit design of the level.
Got it.
Granted, you'll rapidly find a dead end if you don't go the right way, but they're trying to lead you with light. So to your left. Oh, there's more light there.
Okay.
So you follow that light.
Okay, I'm going.
Just a bit farther.
Ah!
Don't worry, he's gonna.
Okay.
No, he's gonna make little drones shoot her.
Oh, got it. Thank you, Atlas.
Now, would you kindly find a crowbar or something?
Yeah. So jump and push forward.
Splicer, seal Johnny in.
Yeah. There you go, and you have your wrench.
I see it.
It's all lit up for you.
I know. I'm so excited. Okay.
The last weapon you'll ever need in this game.
Okay. So now I just do this a lot. Okay. Got it.
Okay.
Where do I go?
So in front of you, back behind you.
Behind this.
That
way.
Was in front of you. It's lit up.
Oh, so. I know, but there's stuff in the way.
Yeah, but now you're gonna crouch.
Oh.
Yeah. 3D
this
tactics.
This way. Oh no,
we'll
it's
smash
just
it.
Supposed
yeah.
to smash.
There you go. And crouch.
And
wow,
bounce.
Yeah.
Strong. One hit and you break it.
Duck and weave. And he's gonna kick this.
Oh down. God! What do I do?
Yeah, lateral movement, or just let it lose all momentum and sidestep it.
Okay, wait. I'm trying to stand up. Why is it flat? Am I standing?
Yes.
Oh, so I was. I was just going down and up
and
down and up.
Now we're gonna brain him.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Did you? Oh, we have the first aid.
Oh, we need to get Electro Bolt. So okay. See, game won't let us through.
So now we go to this place.
I do have to say, I do love the ads in this game.
Yeah.
If only advertisements went back to this.
I know. The thing is, it's like the style of the game is so cool.
Oh, yeah.
Well, because the 1920s is a cool era.
It's, yeah, it's got a wonderful charm to it.
20s, 30s, 40s, 50s, all those eras are pretty cool.
Not that they're all the same.
No, very different. That's why I said them each separately. Okay, do I have to do something? No. This is.
Yeah. Abigail, calm down. Your genetic code is being rewritten.
Oh
it's
my
not
gosh.
A big deal.
Everything is fine. Keep calm.
Yeah, this is what peak performance looks like.
Oh, I was trying to figure out what I was hearing, and my phone has the audio on, so I'm hearing
someone
myself.
Someone is saying drugs are not classic. I agree.
I said this in my channel.
What,
that drugs
BioShock
are not
represents the problem of drug addiction?
I did not say that, but look, now you know.
It's the core theme of this game. It's not playing GOG with your genetic code. It's just injecting. And it's the second dose, the one that makes you feel a little under the weather. Yeah, it might give you Electro Bolt, though.
That is a great mask. See you floating. Perfect for
it's
Purim.
So great.
Purim is coming up this week, for anyone who was wondering.
Let's definitely draw comparisons.
Purim is a Jewish holiday where we dress up. Clearly not like this, though. We're not gonna...
I mean, I would love to do a Big Daddy costume for that. That'd be fantastic.
That's fun.
Look, Mr. Bubbles, it's an angel.
First time this part of the game happened, he played this around.
Coming from his belly. Wait a minute. He's still breathing.
It's so creepy.
It is.
It's all right. I know he'll be an angel soon.
But like once you learn about the little sisters and everything, we played this in around Halloween.
Mm-hmm.
And so it was Spooktober. The entire month I kept saying to Jacob, it's Spooktober. So the little sister storyline was very moving to me.
Oh, yeah. Also, the character of Atlas is responsible for me in high school being incredibly irritating by using the phrase boyo.
is that right?
Yeah, here
you
and there.
You never told me that.
Because you forget the stupid things.
Oh, am
you
I
do.
Supposed to use this on this?
Yes.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It, like your hand, is made of electricity.
God, was I standing under the door?
No. It's the plane.
Oh, God!
Yeah, they're going to want to keep moving.
Oh, forward? Okay.
For your enemies, and also for you, I guess.
Wait,
so,
do I have to crouch?
Seek higher ground.
Do I jump?
Yeah, no, you go up and around.
Do I jump?
No, you go up and around.
Okay.
Into the body of the plane.
Oh!
Up.
See, around. I'm not intuitive with this stuff.
I really wish that there was like a deployable slip and slide ability so that you could just body surf. Totally would fit with the tone of this game.
The theme of this game, the theme and tone. Yeah, I'm gonna take a look at what
the
people are
saying. Friend. Oh, no, it's just a corpse.
Thank you for telling me I'm doing great. I'm working hard.
You
need
to
get
it right. Where is our friend? Oh, there you are. Come here. Come here.
I see the Titanic, guys. Got it. Uncontrollable water.
Come on, I can control.
That's part of the game.
Oh, very much a central conceit to this game.
See, so you're supposed to learn how to do more things throughout the game than just having electricity and the wrench. But I find that the electricity and the wrench were perfectly good for me. So that's what I stick with.
Yeah.
And that's what I stuck with the entire game last time we played.
There you go.
Okay.
You're
going to
come across the lady who has got a gun carriage.
Oh.
Yeah, a revolver that she treats like a baby.
That's not going to...
Yeah. It's going to be a good time.
Yeah, I was going to say, that does not sound...
If you can reach them in Neptune's bounty, then maybe...
Who's the older of the two of you?
I'm older. By 4 months.
4 months.
So that was 4 months, and we're in them right now.
Mm-hmm.
It's cougar season.
Is that classic Abigail?
I got that from another Instagram influencer that I follow who said she is 10 days older than her husband, mm-hmm. and during those 10 days she'll say, it's cougar season. I thought that was hilarious. So.
So speaking of cradle robbing, you're about to go take a gun from the woman who has it in her
Should we
carriage.
Explain what's happening for those people who we've been talking over stuff? So basically we're Atlas is this guy.
Observe the creepy though. Because once you fight her, this is going to go away. Stop. Let her say her depressing insanity.
Okay. Why is it today and not then when you were warm and sweet? Why can't Mommy hold you to her breast and feel your teeth? Oh, no.
So yeah, I will say to this game's absolute credit, and this is... a good presentation of games as art. We're going to make our political critiques and everything like that, but that's...
Yeah.
Just policy and perspective. As art, BioShock is fantastic. It's got a lot of pathos. It really accomplishes a lot. And so just little audio things, the voice actors, all of it, it comes together extremely well. This game is very poignant. Now bash your head in with the wrench.
Oh my god.
There we go.
Sorry.
Now take the revolver that is about 5 feet long.
So Atlas is this guy who's kind of giving us guidance about where we need to go, and he told us that his family has been taken
by the dictator of the city, the industrialist Andrew Ryan with the giant statue of his own head. Many of you have played this game or have had it spoiled for you and you're familiar with it. Maybe not everyone has, because the game did come out in 2007, 2008.
I didn't know the spoilers, so I don't think we should spoil it.
Yeah, we don't need to.
Yeah.
Oh, Happy New Year, 1959.
You guys are getting follows out the rear. I'm flying. Thank you for the follow.
So, for those of you wondering, we've got a friend here from Yap helping us.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, there he is, right there. Can I say your name? Yep, Kyle's here. So, Kyle's helping us out, and he's taken control of the chat when we are both focused on the game and helping us out there. So, some more... masks, because they're celebrating New Year's. Not Purim, as you might have guessed.
Someone did ask if we finished Control and what was our opinion on it. We did not finish
Control yet.
We just happened to stall while we were doing other things, and we will go back to it. The game is really cool. It's got great kinetic combat, everything like that. The story is a little sci-fi original channel movie-esque in certain ways, and just... I don't know. The characterization doesn't pull us in. It's fine. And so because of that, we're not drawn in where we have to keep playing.
Yeah,
so it's sputtered out a little bit. We will go back to it.
I mean, it's also much more complicated with the mechanics than this is for me.
Yes.
So I can do this. I cannot do Control. So I watch Jacob play Control mostly.
Which also cuts down on the fun of doing it.
A little bit less.
Yeah.
Jimmy Nojan, thanks for the sub.
Do you think that's a child down there? Don't be fooled.
So you got a lot of fans asking, or basically saying, It'd be great to see you guys stream more.
Well, thanks, guys.
Well, don't speak too soon, guys. It's been all of about 20 minutes.
You don't know how the rest of this time is
going to
be.
If you don't move from this scaffolding, she's just going to keep poking that corpse forever.
Oh, I thought I was supposed to walk around the scaffolding.
You are. I'm saying that, like it's like an, excuse me, animatronic at like Pirates of the Caribbean, where it just kind of like does its thing over and over.
By Mr. PR80 says, oh my. Dump the wrench and support the Second Amendment.
Well, hey, to that, if we're able to swing a wrench so hard that we can kill a mutant in one hit, then those guns on our character are plenty of support already.
No, I mean, I would do both. I just have terrible aim.
Oh,
wait, I have to watch.
We gotta watch this moment. Oh,
man.
Wait. Look to the right.
Hello, Jacob.
Hello.
Hello. As you see, things are afoot.
So this is a big daddy.
Yeah, keep him in frame. Yeah, we're now playing amateur cinematographer.
I am the most amateur when it comes to that. So as you can see, this guy is protecting the little girl.
There we go. So, conceit of this game, as you may notice, is there's superpowers. Why are there superpowers? They are not called superpowers. They're called plasmids. A thing in this game is you have your underwater society made to be some hyper-libertarian utopia. They happen to discover this material underwater and these sea slugs that let you rewrite the genetic code of people. Naturally, of course, it becomes superpowers, but...
Should I save? It told me to save.
Yeah, sure, save.
Okay.
So people use this material to rewrite the genetic code. It gives them all kinds of abilities. A thing that's going to come up in the game in like the first section is there's a plastic surgeon you have to fight who would use it to like completely reshape people. And he was inspired by Picasso, so the reshaping he did of people was cubist and unfortunate, but it had an effect on people of making them go mad and basically was responsible for the city's downfall. But the artistic premise of the game is, yeah, the genetic rewriting drove people crazy and destroyed the city, but really it was the inherent degenerate philosophy of the city that made something like this inevitable, even without the superpowers. But yeah, that's why you're seeing superpowers. The little girls exist to recycle the genetic rewriting material that's in the corpses,
like,
called
Adam.
Adam
and Eve, those two things.
Yeah. So you're gonna wanna.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I forgot. I was involved in the storytelling. I'm not aimed right.
So you see the cursor in the center of the screen?
Yeah.
The looks like you scratched a camera lens.
Yeah.
Put that on them.
Okay.
And then pull the trigger.
Yeah.
And then you will wrench them.
Okay, got it.
From
this
mortal coil.
Sorry, I thought this was a waterfall and I was gonna I don't know what was happening. I'm overwhelmed.
Just proceed.
Should I heal or something?
No, your health is in the top left. You're all good.
Oh.
And you have a bevy of health kits. So just jog
on. Do I
on.
Go down?
Yeah, just jog on.
Whee!
I'm sure your character's saying that internally.
Yeah, I'm sure he is not at all stressed.
See the arrow in the middle of your screen?
Yeah, that's my favorite thing in this game.
It's a pointing you in the direction you should go.
Yeah, I was going to say, this is something in games that I can't do if it's not there. The arrow is very helpful to me. It's necessary to my existence playing these games. So I appreciate that in Bioshock. Oh,
so,
God!
So to reply to Jimmy No John's, Bioshock Infinite would be great since it already takes a critical look at hyper-American nationalism.
Oh, no.
Yes, that game is designed to take on the idea of founding myths and nationalism, and then also quantum entanglement theory and everything like that. The sci-fi element got way too convoluted. But the critique it makes artistically is along those lines, and it does make a really interesting fodder for a conversation and a critique of their critique. Because art itself is fodder for criticism, even if it criticizes.
Yeah, I haven't played Bioshock yet. We started Bioshock 2. We're still in the middle of that. We finished this one. So, yeah.
Yeah, and we were playing through Bioshock 2, and we're chugging along on that.
How do I get out of it?
You just fight people off. It's like a little sidebar. Say, you're gonna wanna beat me.
Oh, God.
Remember to hit B.
I forgot about that.
Hit B.
Oh, God.
B.
Why? Oh, okay.
It gives you health. You're gonna wanna beat him to death.
Oh, God.
Yeah, there you go. There you go. The door opened.
Whew. That's a lot. I was not ready for it. Okay. Did I get all of the stuff? I'm not getting all of the stuff. Okay. Got all the stuff. Now I... No, I still can't go that way. I thought go that was the direction of
the door that opened.
Yes, I understand.
The game is pretty linear.
It makes sense. I just thought I was supposed to go into the fire initially. No. That was wrong.
Neither through fire or by water shall you pass. That's not this kind of a moment.
Ooh, but that is a cool effect in this game. I'm going to walk through the water as you say that. Because that's a cool effect.
Your character in-universe is just standing utter water.
He's like, oh, this is so great. I need a shower.
He's taking a cold shower to, like, think over the murdering 10 people with a wrench he just did in the span of 5 minutes.
It was a lot.
Oh, too bad. Turn around.
Oh, Christ.
You're trapped.
Turn around.
Gonna try to overrun
the exit. You're going to get treated to an Orson Welles radio hour.
Oh, lovely.
Yeah.
So tell me, friend, which one of the bitches sent you? The KGB wolf? The CIA jackal? Here's the news. Rapture isn't some sunken ship.
Someone talking about roller coaster tycoons. Because that is bringing back memories from high school.
There we go. So in terms of plot, you have the great industrialist based on Walt Disney, Howard Hughes, any of those first half of the 20th century billionaires who has this... Yeah, they're... Oh, actually, no, turn around. Yeah. He's urging you to get out of there with all due speed and... Over the door, click A. There you go. The game makes you try and run away from 3 people, even though you just fought 5 people.
Yeah, it doesn't make that much sense.
Sure, why not?
I mean, to be fair, fighting off 3 people immediately after having fought off 5 people.
But you took the cold shower.
That should have helped.
So you're revitalized. You took Regeneron, and now there's no stopping you.
Dr. Steinman's cosmetic enhancement, is that what I'll look like?
I really struggle to say your name because it's just so much for what it is. But Stinky Dinks, which is a fun thing to say out loud regardless, that is how we purchased the game. We did get the 3-pack. We got Bioshock Remastered on Switch, because we do have a Switch and I thought that might be more fun for us or more portable, but trying to play a shooting game on
it's
the
not
Twitch,
great.
The right stick is so imprecise for aiming that we just defaulted to smacking everything with a wrench, which remains the default strategy in my opinion. But we repurchased it when it was on sale for $10 the other day, and so now we have it all on Xbox.
So you can see, I'm just showing you guys kind of the world a little bit, because it's cool. Medical Pavilion is clearly doing great. The sign is hung perfectly straight. One person stood back and watched, made sure it was straight. They were like, perfect.
It's tastefully askew, like a classic hat worn by Frank Sinatra.
Exactly.
That was their model. They looked to Sinatra for their sign hangings.
It's great.
So you're going to want to wander around here.
Oh.
Do you want to hand it over to me to wander?
Yeah, you wander. I'll look a little bit.
In my case, not all who wander are lost.
He's the pro.
Oh, Abigail, audio log.
Oh, I love these.
Okay, come on. Play the diary. There we go.
Dr. Steinman said he released me today. Ryan didn't come to see me since the New Year's attack, not once. But Dr. Steinman was very attentive. He told me that once the scar tissue was gone, he was going to fix me right up, make me prettier than any girl I've ever seen.
Raise your hand if you think this is not going to turn out well for that lady.
She was, so as I was explaining before, you had the billionaire industrialist who ran the city, and so, there we go. So he's based on Walt Disney, Howard Hughes, those classic billionaires, and he wanted to create this hyper-libertarian utopia so that men with his ambitions could avoid being constrained by communism or American welfarism or religiosity, anything like that, you know, self-actualization to the most self-regarding, selfish degree. And so he is the one who, in the chaos of the city, ended up using a pheromone system that affects the people who splice up with that atom stuff so he can make a private army. And so that's who's opposing this. He's the Chechnya vodka. There we go.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, you know, you're trying to deal with having killed 10 people or whatever.
The cold shower clearly didn't do enough.
Cold shower followed by 12 bottles of Chechnya vodka is the winning move.
God.
Yeah, I hope
this sounds. I can't even look at this. I'm so sorry for all of you guys, but
it's
watch.
Gone now.
Woo!
Our character is a heavyweight. But yeah, so Andrew Ryan is the guy, and we are here just to find our way out of the city. And he thinks we are some foreign spy, and so he's sicking all these brainwashed, mutated people.
So how does he control them?
Pheromone system.
Okay. Yeah. Are saying. Someone asked if I'm a Mario or Luigi stan.
The answer is clearly Monty Mole.
Jacob
the
is
only
a Monty
worthy
Mole
character
fan.
In Mario Party is Monty Mole. Because he
I mean,
just,
I always choose Princess
prime.
Peach. I think Princess Peach is very cute. But I grew up playing, I wasn't allowed to play video games. Not that I wasn't allowed. My
actually,
family just...
We forgot what we do next. So why don't you...
You figure this
yeah,
out.
Yeah, you take care of that.
I did not grow up playing video games. It wasn't that I wasn't allowed. We just didn't own anything. But my grandmother owned an original Nintendo. And the original Nintendo had the original Mario. And so we played Mario, and I could play the first two levels, like, perfectly. And I know where all of the hidden secrets are. So I guess I would have to say, if I had to choose between Mario or Luigi, I would say Mario. Clean it up! Clean it up! Not that you necessarily needed that much time, but there you go. Well, people were interested.
All these people are coming to party.
I was gonna say, that's a lot. People were, saying Wario.
Oh, he's also
Wario's fun. Pretty fun.
He's my boy.
What genres of music do I listen to other than classical music? I listen to... What do you call, like, would that be alternative?
Well, according to Spotify, it gave the worst name, Greek folk. Which
I don't feel good about it.
Yeah.
I don't feel
no,
good about
I'd say
it at
alternative
all.
Folk.
Yeah.
No, the Denver Banhart is absolutely one of our favorite singer-songwriters.
Yeah, we like him. And then, but I listen to jazz. I listen to obviously classical. I listen to some country. I'm very broad with the things that I listen.
You're very
to.
Ecumenical.
Yeah.
Those tracks is excellent commentary from both of you. I'm excited to see more of it.
Oh my god. When can we send you the check? This diamond.
I'm guessing she does not look great.
She looks as
Wait,
beautiful
why are there
as Picasso.
In this game?
So, okay. This game is a spiritual successor to a sci-fi game called System Shock, which was apparently landmark in video gaming.
Okay.
And that was like sci-fi in the future in a space station. Ooh, wait. Oh, he does have a beautiful signature in blood.
Well,
gotta
I was
going to
say,
credit.
I don't believe him. But above all, do that.
He just defines harm through an alternative metric.
Ah.
In this society, they overlap with the woke. They say that, you know, everyone can have their own kind of cultural performance of standards.
Right.
It's oppressive for you to say that you know what harm is in advance. It applies to everyone.
Fair. There
and
you
clearly,
go.
Whatever happened here... is just a beautiful and unique expression of what not doing harm looks like.
There you go. It all makes sense now. Yeah, so this surgeon is not the person we want to go to.
I mean, both of you will love Picasso and hate yourself.
I mean, even if you love Picasso, I'm not sure you'd want it on your face.
Well, that's where hating yourself comes into play. Whoops, deactivated
See,
my own
I just
want to
point
thing.
Out, look how much better Jacob is at this game.
I am also on easy mode, but please do give me credit.
I mean, still, Wait. You like are moving much more smoothly than
Let's,
I am. Oh, and I can't do these hacks as quickly as you can. Not nearly as quickly.
There we go. Oh, come on. Give me a vertical. There we go. Another vert. I did not do this in an efficient manner. whatsoever. So while I'm immersed everything. In this, please do let me know what the people are clamoring.
Yeah, for. I'm looking at
people call out. What do they call out for?
I'm taking a look.
Oh, another diary. These people, just the most obsessively self-documented people outside of Zoomers. Xbox One X. Yeah, boo it. Boo it all you want, PlayStation boy. I buy American. Because that matters in software these days. That may actually have been why I first started with Xbox in like 2002. And now I would not care when it comes to tech companies, because if they're not going to be patriotic, I will not consider buying them to be the same.
Right.
Okay.
Okay, so we've got a...
Oh, hey! This is a...
Oh, God!
Oh.
Jacob, you're going to lose!
That's fine. We'll be fine.
You got to put on the link!
I'm looking for that.
No, there's one right there!
Okay, you're Russian.
I'm not Russian. I mean, I'm part of
Russian. Yeah. Oh, I do puns. This isn't tedious. What are you talking about?
Well,
this
I can't do it as content. Fast as you can. So I find it cool. I don't know. These remind me of the games like Tetris thing. Again, very limited games I used to play as a child. So Mario and Tetris was another one. And Family Feud and Wheel of Fortune. They were so old that the sound
Do you want to talk about our favorite place ever? The Circus of Values.
The Circus of Values.
You know what?
Don't get more vodka.
You're right.
Potato chips. You know what? At least he's not wandering around double vision situation.
Yeah, no. Now he's just fat and unhappy with himself. Oh, good. More potato chips. You can get them for free in this place, apparently.
Someone here said this is how hacking works in real life.
Hacker man. Okay. There we go. Oh, wait. Trophy. Can you do anything with this trophy?
You can carry it around and show that you're a winner.
It's probably a participation trophy.
In this world, I doubt it. That's just you buy the trophy.
Yes.
Yeah, you know, it doesn't matter if you want to.
That's what
or
it
not.
Is. I'll be right back.
Okay, Kyle, you're gonna have to give me some chat things while Jacob's out here. Okay, thank goodness there's the arrow to tell me what to do next. Is that right?
Do you think Margaret? So this one comes from Freaklet. Do you think Margaret Thatcher effectively realized she was going to be my funnel? Oh.
But once what?
No, it's a dummy.
And then I'll be sure to tell Ryan. Yeah, trolls are always a fun part of live streams.
Not a troll, it's just a dumb question.
Gotcha. Well, we're now in this beautiful... I mean, honestly, I love these tunnel things. If BioShock wasn't about a terrible society, I think this would be a cool place to visit. And I'm sad that something like this doesn't exist. And... like a good version of it, like a vacation spot as opposed to this.
So this is an interesting question that we're getting here from Dogports. Who won more Mario Kart, them or you?
We didn't play Mario Kart growing up, but if we had, it would have been Ben, because I always end up accidentally going the wrong direction, so I don't think it would have been as likely that I would have been the person winning these games.
Why do we have 2 eyes?
Like video games or just games? We played board games, my whole family. We would all sit down on Sabbath, and we would play Apples to Apples. We played Settlers of Catan. You know, all of these games that are, I would say, slightly more easy to play, and then I married my husband, who's like board game master. And he plays the hardest games ever, and I can't play anything. I don't know how to do any of it.
If we ever do a math dating stream of a board game,
sorry.
You're good.
Well, I mean, if we're playing Here I Stand, the Wars of the Reformation, 1517 to 1555, well then yeah, that's an 8 to 20 hour board game that I still have not opened.
Pretty Jesus is that you need your own character in your way.
Me? It, like,
do you see yourself beating on Wario or Bowser?
I'm really bad at Smash Bros. I'm like,
but your avatar can represent your potential.
I feel
to,
like
kick
she,
butt if someone else were in the
she kicks butt with seat. Manners and
poise.
Poise.
No, grace and elegance.
Her makeup brushes.
So, another person, Silverheart, asks, "What's the family Thanksgiving dinner?"
They're great. My mom is an amazing cook, and so she makes an incredible turkey. The best is the stuffing. Stuffing is always awesome. And we have a lot of family there, which is always nice. But it also, it's funny because I used to do it at home, right? But now I'm married, and I used to kind of go to my husband's family for
yes.
Thanksgiving, which is also lovely. And I love his family's Thanksgiving. They're super special. So, bet you they don't have Thanksgiving here. In BioShock.
Well, giving things implies you're not entitled to whatever you acquire by the sweat of your brow. So if you can manage
right.
it, then it's yours.
Go get
Why
her!
Would you
get her! 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 Get her!
Solid move. I think you. Now that you've damaged her left eardrum by firing your gun right next to it, you can follow up with the strike.
Okay, I'm gonna be honest. I thought I had the wrench in my hand. I did not wrap you guys.
It's a very revolver-shaped wrench, but that's just because you're trying to smuggle a wrench into the shooting
range. Oh, God! Get here! Wait! Ah!
I've never seen a better boxing match.
Oh, my goodness. Okay. I think I got everything. What does that say?
Steinman kills.
I think that's true.
So my question about that message,
okay.
And it's a very nuanced, sophisticated, high-level question.
Tell me.
Who is that for?
I feel
if you're in the society and there's enough blood around for you to write it on the ground, the pool of possible audience members would already be familiar with Steinman and his killing nature.
I mean, I don't know. I feel like it could also
it's
be
It's a waste of blood. I feel wherever you're acquiring it from.
I mean, the blood is already, like, wasted. It's on the ground.
Would it be?
I think so. Where am I supposed to go now? This way?
I mean, they're downstairs.
Downstairs.
I believe. That's not downstairs.
This is not the stairs.
That is
down.
Outside.
Okay.
Yes.
Someone says, Abby's seeing Old Town Road. Maybe when we add the Patriot points back.
Yeah, she
has done so. Oh, wait, we have to acquire... May I have the control?
Yeah, go get fire.
We have
fire.
To acquire fire. Yeah, acquire the fire. You have to be real Promethean here. So
I did sing when I was in... When we first moved to Nebraska, I sang Old Town Road in an opera voice. So that was on Twitter. But yes, that's something that we will do. Do you want me to explain Patriot points? I don't really know how they work. Do you know how they work exactly?
He can do it.
Can you explain?
What's up, fam? You can't see me. I'm the secret hidden gnome in the corner of the room.
Calling yourself a gnome, so I don't have to insult you with it first. Roll of hope.
Points you guys accrue that just by watching this. You also accrue another point, the freedom token. Patriot points.
Freedom token.
Yes, sir.
That's amazing.
I'm not scoffing. I'm just appreciating the consistent branding.
So Patriot points will allow you, once we're going to have some creative, unique ones when you guys have the Roths on, the right angle, and classically Abby. We'll come up with some ones that are fun that you guys will enjoy. And then when other staff on, then we'll have different things. You'll see, for example, the magic bean, where we want to torture ourselves with Bean Boozled, for those of you who know. Or Jacob also has this scary collection that is growing of hot sauces, and we may work that in.
All specifically kosher, so I have no excuse not to consume them.
Yes, you can't try to pull an exemption out.
Yeah, which I couldn't do with the Bean Boozled either, because Jelly Bellies are also kosher. So just, there is no escape.
And then the Patriot, or the Freedom Tokens, we eventually will link to actual swag, like t-shirts and hats, sunglasses.
Oh, that's cool.
And buttons and things like that. So yeah, thank you everybody for the follows and the subscribers. For follows, I don't know the exact ratio, but you get the more you follow, the more points you get. The subs get more. It's a multiplier. And then the higher level sub you are, the more stuff you accrue at a time. And then for freedom tokens, you can actually play in games.
I just want people to observe the little ads. I really wish more products were advertised as succinctly and stylistically as that.
I mean,
perhaps
it's...
Perhaps the ads for this,
Wow, I missed it.
I love it.
That would require a little bit of effort on someone's part to draw up, but I would appreciate that immensely. There you go.
I've actually seen that one. That's right. And
so,
also,
does the fire want to go out? Oh, there we go. But the plastic dummy of a human body does not.
I would have thought that was a dress form, but I think this is not the place for that.
Yeah, I mean, with Steinman, who knows?
Fair enough. He could be sewing
skin,
in his free time.
He turns your skin into the dress.
Terrible.
Yeah.
Stop.
Exactly.
Please.
Blame Steinman, not me. He kills the moment. That's
I
what
mean,
he
does.
So as we were saying.
I don't remember what I was saying.
I apologize.
It's okay.
Ooh. Oh, Surgery's
Picasso.
Picasso.
There you
that
go.
Same signature. Do you think he used a stencil?
Well, he definitely has a paintbrush.
Yeah. So, and that is... she's beautiful.
Stunning.
She's gorgeous. So is her nose off to the left?
No, I think he shaved it. I think that's
no,
like...
No, but did he put it back on the top left, or are those just mock-ups?
I think those are mock-ups.
Those are mock-ups?
Yeah.
I can't tell.
I mean, it's an unfortunate photo, no matter what it is.
Why does he get to remain looking like that?
I don't know. He doesn't seem to do this much on, like, the men. Mostly he's going to town.
Definitely
making...
not a complex.
Yeah, so... Let's see. Over and over again. The upturned nose, the clipped chin, the ample nose. Seeing what people are doing. It would be wonderful if I could do with a knife what that old
Spaniard did with a brush. Ah, can't get in there.
I don't know, man.
Want to get diary. Don't want to be caught on camera.
Yeah, this is not your favorite.
It's
you
not.
Like
I keep going out of my way to do it, though. So
I know, I was going
to
say.
That's,
why?
Masochism? I don't know.
But you said in the Bioshock 2 you prefer
it's,
the hacks.
It's so
Bioshock
much. Well, first of all, what's interesting about it is that they made it so that the game does not pause. We could be in the middle of fighting, and it wouldn't affect anything
right.
here. So it doesn't pause, and it's not made strategic. It's just made reflex-based.
Yeah.
I don't care. I'm not doing that.
Yeah. Not worth it. We don't need
Juice,
it.
Juice, squeeze, not equal.
Okay.
Clinical trial, lot 44, Dr. Suchong, client, Fontaine Futuristics.
Ooh, get back there. This is irritating to me.
Oh, I'm listening to the thing.
Can you hear me, Mr. Wallace? Yes, sir, Mr. Stu Thompson. Very well. Right, I'm introducing Lot 44 now.
Oh, now I can't. Name the Lot
44 in rage. What? You can see it.
Oh, there you go. Wait, so they did Picasso a man.
No, that's not Picasso anymore. That's using the enraged plasmid on
him.
Yeah, that's what they were just saying.
Got
oh,
it.
Look, shotgun in room with dodgy lighting.
Not
and
great.
Person.
Don't zoom in.
Don't zoom. Okay, fine. I'll
don't
just
do it.
Step over the corpse to grab a shotgun.
People are saying that Daft Punk broke up today.
Oh, I'd seen about that.
I don't know anything about Daft Punk.
You're good. They're not terrible, they're just a genre of music that you and I are not particularly
well, I
into.
I feel like there was a specific era in which people talked about that.
Early 2000s? Not that early? No, No. Didn't they do One More Time? Or am I just showing complete cultural ignorance?
Please check the chat
to see if I'm...
Correct.
Yeah, no, you know what?
Chat, tell us about Daft Punk.
It's
we
like
don't
Who
know.
Wants to Be a Millionaire? You let the audience correct you because you know they're right. I use Chomper's Dental Office.
The Yap Fan chat.
Just live correct.
It says, what's been your favorite games this gen? Xbox One?
I just saw someone say that Daft Punk did do One More Time, so...
Oh, did they? Oh, yes, they did One More Time. Okay, got it.
This mattered. This mattered so much.
But which games do you like better, Xbox One or PS4?
I don't have a PS4.
Oh. That's the answer!
Yeah!
What's the thing? PlayStation?
We don't have PlayStation. We have a Nintendo Switch. Yes, Abigail. Abigail is very new.
I'm so sorry. I don't know.
Let me pretend that I have any right to scoff at you because I played video games throughout my youth and you were learning a skill like singing.
I wasn't learning it when I was a child. That's fine.
Well, you were learning Korra while I was doing video games. So
fair
I
enough.
Give you credit for that.
Yeah.
Who's,
I mean,
who's fighting
schooling.
Me? Who wants to fight? Come on. There we go. I feel like Floyd Mayweather trying to bait someone to throw a grenade and then just launch it right back at them.
Do you like the Beatles?
Do I like the Beatles? So, I think the Beatles are fine. I'm not a huge fan of their music. There are certain songs I really like.
Aesthetics are a moral imperative.
So, that's a statement.
Yeah, so I will say this is actually a handy little reference point for just... Idolatry comes in many forms, and we associate paganism with the ancient world. Paganism, idolatry, are anything that is finite that you put in the seat of the infinite. If you let something as cramped and limited as a thing that you like or that could have some value, and you mistake that for all that there is to value, you will sacrifice far too much for the sake of something that's far too small.
Well, and it's often said that the idea that there's been civilizations that were beautiful and valued beauty and did things, so beauty is not moral.
It's not sufficient. It is nourishing. It is a vehicle to get across that which is maybe more abstract and appealing, like real moral messages. Couching it in proper aesthetics makes it better. It's like having vitamins or medicine that you put good flavoring on.
Right.
It's going to get people to encourage you to do the right things, but the good flavoring itself is not the medicine.
Right, exactly.
Oh, this is him speaking to Aphrodite, speaking of paganism. Oh, there he is.
There he
We're
goes.
We're going to fight him. Come
he's
on,
a boss,
bro.
Right?
Come on.
That's what you call that? A boss?
Yeah, he's a boss.
He's a boss.
We don't have to compliment the guy, Abigail. Oh, wait, I want to hack this. There we go. Okay, what's chat saying now? What are they up to?
The people in the chat?
Yeah.
I was going back to the Beatles. Yeah, the Beatles are not my favorite, but I like some of their songs. They're, like, perfectly fine to listen to. I just don't find them that engaging. And growing up, my dad really didn't like the Beatles, so I think that's probably part of it. But going back down here, somebody said, what was it? They asked if I've ever watched anime. No. I have not.
Do you have any interest?
Not really. I have nothing against anime, it's just that I, like, for other people, I just don't find it. I just am not the biggest fan
way,
of the
boy.
Art. It's not my favorite.
World Traveler. There's some subtle ways leftists put their ideology in video games that players may not notice before.
That is a good question.
That is a very good question.
I mean, because you play more video games.
Yeah, video games more specifically are my domain. So. First of all, I just want to let any moment in the game breathe.
Yeah, fair enough. Yeah, it's not good.
An intruder. He is ugly. Ugly. Ugly.
It's very rude.
What
That's
I lament about this game is that they never let you see a mirror so that you can confirm whether or not Steinman was completely insane. Maybe the man had a point.
To be fair, he's the only person in the world who thinks that being too symmetrical is ugly.
Oh, he's dead already.
Wow.
I guess on easy mode, launching a crate into his head with telekinesis is sufficient.
Make sure you get the key off.
Yeah,
fair point.
Also, superpowers and people tanking multiple bullets before going down happens too, so. Mm-hmm. Look, the game designers programmed this nice little combat arena that we could have electroshocked him in, And then they still let him go down. You don't even need it. They let him go down like a punk with one crate launched via telekinesis into the face.
But going back to that question.
So the way that the left can put a message into a video game, you know, to think of something unique, it'll take me a moment. But broadly, it's the same way that you can put it into anything, which is that you frame the facts of a narrative. For example, you make a game about Vietnam. What are you going to do? You're going to have the obligatory, like, war crime sequence or something like that for the U.S. Or you won't focus on why the North was fighting the South. You're going to just make it seem like a generic conflict that the U.S. also did a war crime. Just anything like that. A really big problem when it comes to artistic representations of historical events is what the audience will assume to be neutral that is actually politicized. So as I was saying with Vietnam, you know, oh, well, everyone just knows that X thing is historically what happened. Well, how do you know that? The way we talk about current events now and the way we frame anything is always politically charged. You look at something like the Iraq War. There's no neutral narrative about deciding to go to Iraq or what went down there or the justifications for doing it. All of that is a series of debates to be had about people's motives and about what all that means.
Right.
Well, so you go back to any historical epoch,
I mean, and it's
they'll
true.
Get away with treating their own narrative as just the established fact that we all know. So that's a really big thing. You see it in movies,
right.
Games
I was
can
say,
accomplish
the same
thing.
You see that in movies.
Thing.
I talked about that with The Crown. It's very easy to see it in historical films because they're not, there's obviously a narrative and they're obviously trying to get across their viewpoint. And it's even easier to see it when you can consult history and say, okay, did that really happen?
We had a flashback to that amazing cigarette we had at the beginning of the game.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, wait, I am going the wrong way though. Whoops. There we go.
But yeah, so it's easy to actually confirm biases because you can look at the history and say, okay, well, they're not giving us the whole story. And that's true in video games and it's true in movies.
Yeah. Before we continue, and that was a good question, thank you, let's get a little cutscene. So we just saw a Big Daddy mm-hmm. launched through a wall. Oh, wait, we can't jump there. We have to walk through the door. Like a pleb. So, okay, we have a moment here. This is the introduction to the morality system in the game, which is extremely binary. Basically, you have these little girls, as we were describing, and you can rescue them.
This is such a moving thing, in my opinion.
Yes, but before we go on, I'll set up a little background for it.
Yeah.
So, we describe the society underwater, hyper-capitalist, no gods, no kings, no masters. Great. They discover this genetic rewrite material, gives them superpowers, rots your brain, and then apparently makes you susceptible to being pheromone chemical brainwashed. Great. But the thing is that with the collapse of the society and everything else, they don't have enough of this atom material to go around and keep people stable and keep this little ecosystem functioning. So apparently these little girls were able to be genetically modified so that they could harvest the atom from corpses, reprocess it, and then put it back into circulation, which makes them a big target for these Spicer mutant people who, if they can get a hold of them, can extract tremendous amounts of the atom to keep themselves going. So we, as the player character, to become stronger, need this atom stuff to rewrite ourselves, add the superpowers. And so when we come across these little sisters, as they are called, you have the morality choice. Rescue them, gives you less of the atom, or harvest them, gives you more. Also, it makes you a very mean and terrible person. And the game has two endings, a mean and terrible one, which is if you harvest them, and a nice and fuzzy, genuinely heartwarming one if you rescue them.
Everyone's saying to harvest, we will not harvest.
Yeah, no.
We're not gonna do
yeah,
that.
Yeah, no.
So, sorry about that.
No, there we go.
No.
I like the little music sting.
I do too. And it's much better in the first game, I think.
Yeah. Thank you,
Mister. And she's much cuter in the first game.
Thank you for helping me.
She's like a linebacker. She just pushed us across the room.
I think you're a fan. I lost what happened, but Jacob, somebody said, have you ever heard of Crusader Kings?
Playing you.
So. I don't get so. There's a whole thing with Atlas, and there's a twist in this game. He's not necessarily the nicest guy. But the whole pitch that the little sisters aren't little girls anymore, I don't even get how that's possible.
We literally just saved her, and she was a little girl.
Well, even before then. Okay, she looks like a mutant. She looks like a slug person. Granted, she has like a reverb voice that sounds like a demon in a movie that's possessing some of the little Echo.
Right.
Granted. And they're brainwashed to try and stab corpses with syringes to harvest and reprocess their blood. Granted. But everything they do is very little girl-esque, and they're just like brainwashed.
It's true.
There's like a plot point in the game about once they're saved, they still like go through the motions and have a draw to like try and do the Atom stuff, because that was just like mental programming.
Right.
So, with the addition of superpowers, they are not any less little girl or human.
Right.
They're just little girl plus in an unfortunate manner.
Yeah, no.
You're getting props in the chat for being pro-life.
Of course. Hello.
Yeah, see, that's how we know that we have degenerate leftists in the chat telling us to harvest the little sisters. Gather a vulnerability. They're going to talk to us about the big daddies or the bodyguards.
Right. I think I had another question. Oh, people were asking if there were any classic horror movies. I don't watch horror movies unless they're so ridiculous I can laugh at them because they scare me. But somebody was saying maybe the like old classics, like the black and white stuff. I think that could be interesting.
Well, we do need to watch Gaslight.
Yeah, I was saying someone said like the old Frankenstein or something like that.
Young Frankenstein?
Young Frankenstein I would not call a horror movie.
What do you mean? It's in black and white and Frankenstein's in it. How could it possibly not be? So, yeah, they're telling us that you implant the slug into the little girl, then make her a little sister, they become codependent, now they're saying if you remove the slug, it's like removing a patient for life support.
Except that we did, and healthy.
Yeah, they came up with a method.
There's
Yap
stuff in the chat.
You're
ready now.
Yeah, I know. Oh, wait, opportunity to fight a big daddy. Yes.
My favorite is if you are curious, I was gonna say. but yours is gonna be harder.
What do you mean? I have a mirror, don't I? I'm good. This is the worst method for fighting a big daddy by far.
Someone asked if I'm going to CPAC this year. We are not going to CPAC this year, unfortunately. But definitely, Yav will be there though, so you should definitely check them out. But I will not.
You could say I'm throwing everything but the kitchen sink. Ah! I think I killed him with the teddy bear.
Oh, wow. Mr.
Man! No! 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 Yes. I was not sure where you were going.
I realize that doesn't make sense, because there's... I don't know if it doesn't except that there's a pizza place where I grew up.
Oh, that's very specific. Yeah. I was about to say, that's very specific.
Listen, Ohio pizzerias in your town? exactly what's on the map for me personally.
I'm so sorry.
Watch out, nades.
There
we go.
Thank you. Yeah. Always.
Consume the child.
No.
Nah.
We're not gonna do that.
Besides, they gift us a teddy bear with goodies, so it's not even an advantage. Yeah, you know what? I think the society
ending
is getting to me. The only way my morality goes down in this game is utterly transactional. Uh-oh.
I'm sure.
That's having an influence.
But yeah, the ending of this game
is go through here.
Much better when you a good person.
You're getting there, babe.
I'm working!
Yeah, to your right.
Oh, God!
Nope. Go around the bottom of the stairs.
No, I was gonna shoot him from underneath, but I wasn't able to.
You could...
What?
Can you go through the door right now? You just got a grenade in your back. Nah, you gotta knock something.
Am I in a boss room?
No, you're just fighting a
guy. You're making me nervous.
To your left, I think there's a door control. That's your right.
That's my right.
Your left. That's your right.
This is the left.
That's literally the exact opposite.
Oh god, direction. Everything's happening.
Now to your right.
I'm scared.
Now go forward.
Okay.
Now look at the glowing thing. Okay! Security alert is activated.
Thanks for your patience.
Do I watch this?
No, you can continue on.
I don't know how I managed it either, to be fair.
Yeah, ignore the guy who's throwing a grenade in your face. Oh, nope.
What? Nope. Running away!
Nope, don't do that.
Why?
Do the opposite of that. Just ignore him or kill him. You can do
it. I was gonna ignore him.
But you want to proceed in the game, right?
Yeah.
So go through the door that just opened. Down.
Oh. Did we just come from that direction?
No, we came from behind you. Now, there we go.
Okay,
Yeah, and I'll pull the lever.
Oh, I go in here.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Except.
There we go.
I did it.
Congratulations.
I am great at video games. Woo! Oh my goodness. Let's see.
Yes, you do get more Adam when you harvest the little sisters. But really, what is the purpose of the game? Just to get better at fighting? No, it's for the moral achievement of the happy ending. But unironically.
But absolutely. I play video games for the story. I do not play video games for the fighting, which is why I don't mind if Jacob plays the game and I just watch, because I like listening. But I'm not, you know, tonight we're going for it. So I'm playing. This is Dark for anyone. Just
oh, yeah. That is a crucified smuggler who was smuggling Bibles, as if that were not on the nose.
Maybe he went mad. Maybe the power got to him.
Someone said, "You guys are great, but so different. How did y'all meet each other?" We are very different, but also very similar.
So, here. Okay, now he's done talking. We made it to the second chapter of the game, second level. Thematically, this level is actually kind of about how outside influence infiltrated this hermetically sealed society, I guess literally and figuratively, at the bottom of the ocean. Mm-hmm. And so this might be a good pausing point for the next time.
Yeah.
And to be terrible, the story of how we met also for next
time.
We'll
save it for next
time.
And
it's full bloom, it deserves at least 5 minutes.
I know, it does take, it takes a good amount of time to talk about. It's something I've been wanting to put on my channel for a while. So
we'll
might
do first draft
live. We'll do this is the first draft on here.
Yeah.
You'll find out.
Yeah, you can watch it here, and then you can watch it on my channel again with even more detail. Mm-hmm. So, yeah.
So, one last thing of among the commentaries. So, first chapter was about introducing you to the world of Rapture and Steinman and that whole narrative of, like, the aesthetics and kind of like an Icarus thing. You know, Icarus flew too close to the sun, melted his wings, fell down. This society with Adam can remake man in any form physically, and that power without any limits led to just a complete degeneration. You know, Babel style, you also go up so high you end up destroying yourself. So you see how people get turned into physical, grotesque monsters because there's nothing grounding them and no paying attention to like a human nature of any kind. Here in the second chapter, we have the religious themes in the society, and then also in terms of narrative about how this hermetically sealed society had smuggling and outside influences kind of be the progenitor for organized crime in the society, which led to people trying to rival Andrew Ryan as the great dictator of the city, who also wanted to be like an anarchist, libertarian capitalist utopia. So there's a lot of layered things here, which makes it really interesting. Mm-hmm. But I will point out, we have here the Great Chain, and the Great Chain is this metaphorical thing in the philosophy of Andrew Ryan about the great chain of commerce and cooperation.
Right.
It's his adaptation and then pagan idolization of a degenerated version of the Invisible Hand. Yeah, the Invisible Hand, the idea that people pursuing their normal run of just business and things to make a living for themselves drives them to act in a pro-social way, which makes sense in the context in which it was originally set. You take anything, remove all limits and normal, just pragmatic grounding, and you make it your god, you're going to get the Great Chain in an explicitly atheist society. You still have a god, you still have religious art, and you still have things that lead people completely astray. There's a great quote that I love from David Foster Wallace, which is, there's no such thing really as an atheist. You don't get a choice about believing. You're going to believe. You just get a choice about what you believe. So this section of the game is a really good kind of presentation of that theme.
Yeah.
So with that, I think the gameplay portion is done.
Yeah.
So we're going to save. And Kyle, what do now? We just do this?
I guess I'm going to switch to intermission and peace out.
So
Sounds good.
During intermission or now for the camera. Thank you for bearing with us as we figure this part out.
All right, there we go. Okay,
oh,
there we
got it.
On the big screen, it's all you.
Oh
my goodness. Okay, well, that was our first part of playing through BioShock. Thanks for hanging out with us while we did it. My Jacob was, you know, doing better than I was. But, you know, I got some things. I did some of it. I ran into some walls. That wasn't the best part.
You ran into some walls, which were your obstacle to overcome.
They were.
And you discovered how to think laterally. Step to the side of the wall and then move forward. Thank you all for viewing. Thank you for participating
for
in the chat.
Us.
And
we'll see
there were some great
time.
Questions this time. And we look forward to more discussion of the game, our lives, conservatism in general. Just
keep asking questions in the chat because we like being able to communicate with you guys. So. Yeah.
It was a lot of fun. Thank you all.
Thanks,
have a great
guys.
Night.
Good night.
Thank you.